As you already know that the PR or PQ interval measures the conduction time from the beginning of atrial depolarization to the beginning of ventricular depolarization and includes atrial depolarization as a P wave and subsequent conduction through the AV node. His bundle. Bundle branches. And terminal Purkinje fibers as a PQ segment. The normal PR interval is considered to be between 120 and 200 milliseconds and tends to shorten with increases in heart rate, due in part to rate-related shortening of action potentials. Normal PQ interval provides normal atrioventricular synchrony when atria contracts before the ventricles. For explaining this, let's briefly remind the cardiac cycle. The cycle begins with depolarization and contraction of the atria, or phase A, atrial systole. It is preceded by the P wave on ACG, which marks depolarization of the atria. Contraction of the left atrium causes an increase in left atrial pressure. The left ventricle is relaxed during this time, and because the mitral valve is open, the ventricle is filling with blood from the atrium even prior to atrial systole. Atrial systole causes a further increase in ventricular volume as blood is actively ejected from the left atrium to the left ventricle through the open mitral valve. The AV valves are closed at the beginning of isovolumetric ventricular contraction phase. The next phases are rapid and reduced ventricular ejection. After ventricular ejection, isovolumetric ventricular relaxation occurs. The AV valves open in a rapid ventricular filling phase and still open in further reduced ventricular filling phase. More details according to the cardiac cycle you can find in another video, link will be in description. Now let's come back to atrial systole. The corresponding blip in left ventricular pressure reflects this additional volume added to the ventricle from the atrial systole. So atrial systole increases and diastolic ventricular volume when atrioventricular synchrony is not impaired. End-diastolic volume increasing, by Friend-Starling law, increases stroke volume, which together with the heart rate form cardiac output. As a result, increasing of stroke volume lead to increasing of cardiac output. Finally, atrial systole contributes up to 25% of cardiac output, and in case of low ventricular compliance, this index can rise even to the 50%. Both atrial output and total peripheral resistance form the mean arterial pressure. First degree AV block is delayed conduction from the atria to ventricles without interruption in atria to ventricular conduction. It is usually defined as prolonged PR interval of more than 200 milliseconds when the heart rate is more than 60 beats per minute and more than 210 milliseconds when the heart rate is less than 60 beats per minute. Usually, first degree AV block isn't related to any symptoms and needs only monitoring. Because it is not impaired atrioventricular synchrony and the cardiac cycle sequence is not changed. But some severe cases of first degree AV block when P wave is near to the previous T or inside the previous ST segment, it can cause pseudopacemaker syndrome that includes weakness, fatigue especially in case of physical activity, diaphoresis, cough, neck pulsation, headache and jaw pain. Physical examination may reveal hypotension, rails, increased jugular veins pressure with Canon A waves, peripheral edema. Because the clinical presentation of pseudopacemaker syndrome is similar to pacemaker syndrome, let's check the features about the pacemaker syndrome. Pacemaker syndrome are the symptoms and signs present in the patient who have had monochamber pacemaker implantation with ventricular stimulation regimen. It is caused by inadequate timing of atrial and ventricular contractions, in other words, in case of atrioventricular synchrony loss due to pacemaker work. It is a pacemaker and electrode that stimulates the right ventricle. This is the right atrium, right ventricle, left ventricle, and left atrium. Pacemaker syndrome related to the ventricular stimulation due to complete AV block, when ventricles are stimulated by the pacemaker's electrode that is located in the right ventricle. On ACG is represented by the white QRS and pacemaker spikes before the QRS. In this case, atria are still depolarized by the sinus node. In this type of stimulation, AV synchrony is lost. Atria contracts not before the ventricles as in physiologic condition, but in random manner toward to the ventricles, for example, in the same time with QRS, inside the ST segment, or merge with the T-wave. Another case of AV synchrony loss is retrograde conduction from the ventricle to atria, when atria are depolarized just after the ventricular depolarization. Let's see the corresponding cardiac cycle changes. When the sinus P-wave is located in ST segment of pacemaker contraction, the atrial systole and left atrial pressure increasing correspondingly occur in rapid ventricular ejection phase. In this time, AV valves are closed, because it will open further in rapid ventricular filling phase, so AV synchrony is lost. The same situation occurs in the case of retrograde ventricular conduction. The similar situation occurs when P-wave is merged with the T-wave. In this case, atrial systole occurs in reduced ventricular ejection phase, when AV valves are still closed. As a result, AV synchrony is lost. So, due to pacemaker syndrome, normal AV synchrony is lost, and atrial kicks occurs against closed AV valves. It means additional blood volume doesn't flow to the ventricles. As a result, end-diastolic volume decreases. Decreasing of end-diastolic volume further by the Frank-Starling law decreases the stroke volume. The stroke volume decline leads to decreasing of cardiac output by 25%. That in its turn decreases mean arterial pressure, therefore cause hypotension. Hypotension leads to weakness, physical activity related fatigue, and diaphoresis. Atrial systole that occurs when AV valves are closed lead to rapid atrial pressure elevation. Right atrium pressure elevation conducts to the systemic veins and causes rapid increasing of systemic veins pressure. This causes pulsation of the neck, face, and abdomen. The pressure also increases in jugular vein that lead to cannon A wave in jugular veins pressure curve. High left atrial pressure conducts to the pulmonary circulation and causes cough and rails in case of fluid transudation into the lung tissue. In case of severe first degree AV block, P wave can be near to the previous T wave or even can be inside the ST segment or T wave of previous contraction. This situation causes the AV synchrony loss, as in case of pacemaker syndrome. This is the way why it is called pseudopacemaker syndrome. Now look at cardiac cycle. When P wave is near to the previous T wave, atria contraction occurs in isovolumetric ventricular relaxation phase. The common features is that during this phase AV valves are closed. Therefore, due to AV synchrony loss, atrial kick doesn't pump additional volume to the ventricles, as a result, end-diastolic volume decreases, stroke volume decreases, and cardiac output decreases too. The decreasing of cardiac output leads to decreasing of mean arterial pressure or hypotension and causes weakness, easy fatigability and diaphoresis. Atrial systole that occurs when AV valves are closed lead to atrial pressure elevation. This pressure conducts from the right atria to the systemic veins and lead to rapid increasing of systemic veins pressure. This rapid increasing of pressure is represented as pulsation of the neck, face and abdomen. High systemic vein pressure means also higher pressure in jugular vein in time of atrial systole. That causes cannon A wave in jugular venous pressure curve. Left atrial pressure bleep further conducts to the pulmonary circulation and causes the cough and rails in case of fluid transudation into the lung tissue. For treating in this condition, dual chamber stimulation is usually used. It means one stimulating electrode is located in the atrium and another in the right ventricle. Thus, firstly atria are stimulated and ventricle stimulation follows the atria. This type of stimulation recovers the atrioventricular synchrony that in its turn restores the cardiac output and relieves the symptoms. Here we go. If you like the content, press like, subscribe to our YouTube and Telegram channel, and have a good day!